infinities of all beings have sometimes been represented by a great tree. The green and budding twigs may represent the existing species, and those produced during each former year may represent the long succession of extinct species. At each period of growth, all the growing twigs have tried to branch out on all sides and to overtop and kill the surrounding twigs and branches in the same manner as species and groups of species have tried to overmaster others in the great battle for life. The limbs divided into great branches and these into lesser and lesser branches were themselves once, when the tree was small, budding twigs. Of the budding twigs which flourished when the tree was a mere bush, only two or three, now grown into great branches, yet survive and bear all the others. So with the species, which lived during long past geological periods, very few now have living and modified descendants. From the first growth of the tree, many a limb and branch has decayed and dropped off. And these lost branches of various sizes may represent those whole orders and families in general, which have now no living representatives and are known to us only from having been found in a fossil state. We, here and there, see a thin, straggling branch springing from a fork low down in the tree, and which by some chance has been favored and is still alive on its summit. This exceptional survivor, in some small degree, connects by its affinities two great branches of life, thus being saved the fatal competition by having inhabited a protected station. As buds give rise by growth to fresh buds, and these, if vigorous, bloom and overtop on all sides many a feebler branch, so by generation, I believe, it has been with the great tree of life, filling with its dead and broken branches the crust of the earth and covering the surface with its ever-branching and beautiful ramifications.
Thank you.